This is the second experiment for week 16. You're going to need a piece of cardboard. You're going to use this for all three steps. You want to make sure that you take a sharp pencil and you're going to poke a hole through it. You want to make sure you poke it completely through so that the hole is wide enough. When you have your toothpaste, after each experiment that you do to show the kids, you're going to want to roll it up tight because you need a lot of toothpaste pressure from the bottom or it just makes a huge mess. And you're going to need lots of paper towels because after you do each experiment, you're going to need to wipe this cardboard clean and do the next one, and it's going to be sticky and messy. So those are some tips to remember. Lots of paper towels. You may want to get a tub of water for you to wash your hands in. Don't let the kids do this. It gets too messy. I've wasted almost an entire tube of toothpaste practicing these out, but I think I've got them figured out. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to show them step one. We're just going to show them how a volcano works. There's magma under the earth. It reaches the crust, and if it's strong enough to break through the crust, then it becomes lava. So I'm going to show, I'm going to make sure my hole is lined up. If your hole is not lined up, it just kind of sticks back on your fingers right here. But so just kind of show them how lava works. Magma comes up through the earth, and then it becomes lava. So that's part one. Part two, you're going to show them how to how a sill is formed, an intrusive igneous rock layer called a sill is formed. And then for step three, you're going to show them how the intrusive igneous rock layer called a laccolith is formed, okay? And so that'll be steps two and steps three.